Hey, Els, Mr. Raines here. Let's talk a little bit about Newton's first law of motion. What you've heard it said is objects in motion remain in motion, and objects at rest remain at rest unless acted upon by an unbalanced force. What does that even mean? All right, so let's talk about objects in motion. What we mean when we say objects in motion is objects moving at the same speed and same direction. That's very important because an object can be accelerating and it's in motion. So that's kind of confusing. So objects moving at the same speed and direction are going to be doing that unless another force acts on it, and an unbalanced force at that. So let's talk a little bit about what happens when that happens. So you're driving in a car and you're going the same speed and direction, and you go around a turn. When you turn, your body instinctively goes that way. Or I know everybody's done it. You've put that Sonic drink or that Starbucks drink right here in the middle console. You turn, you don't even think about it, and that drink goes flying. Why does that happen? Well, it all has to do with the mass of the object. So that mass is going to resist changes in its motion. And that's very important to note. So you're driving the same speed, same direction. So is that cup. That cup's going the same speed and direction as you. You turn and that thing is going to fly. It's not because there's a force causing it to go that way. That's what a lot of people think. It's because it's already in motion and it's going the same speed and direction. When you turn, that causes the object to fly. Well, that's because it's going to continue going in that direction until a force causes it to turn with you. That's why when you put your hand at the cup and you turn, the cup goes with you and it doesn't fly. And that's what we're talking about when we're talking about inertia. Now let's talk about an object at rest. So we look at an object at rest and we have this big, huge rock, and you want to try to push it, but you can't. You're not pushing enough force to overcome the friction of the ground. That's unbalanced forces. Remember, you have to have an unbalanced force. Now you overcome friction. You have enough force to overcome it. It starts moving. It's still going to resist. You feel the rock. It resists its changes in its motion. Otherwise, when you went to push on it, you wouldn't feel the rock. And so that's what inertia is. It's this property of matter that's resisting changes in its motion. Hey guys, let's do an inertia demo real quick. So all I have here is a cup, an index card, and a quarter. This quarter is going to lay right on here. When I apply the force to the card, it's going to slide out from underneath it. However, because of inertia, it's going to hang there until gravity starts working on it. So let's watch that take place.